I got my little Kenley here, and we are in the holiday spirit today. I got my polka dot socks on. I don't know if you can see those. In peppermint, triple chocolate peppermint bark for the holidays, which is so delicious. This hat is not staying on. Okay guys, so what you're gonna need for this recipe for ingredients is 8 ounces of bittersweet chocolate, and I got the Ghirardelli 2 4-ounce bars of baking chocolate. 8 ounces of the white chocolate, and I just got 2 of the 4 ounces of the Ghirardelli white. Ghirardelli is awesome for baking and just awesome in general. Then you're gonna need 30 hard peppermint candies or 4 candy canes coarsely crushed. And then you're gonna need 6 tablespoons of heavy cream, 3/4 teaspoons of the pure peppermint extract. And then you're gonna also need wax or parchment paper, a pencil, a ruler, 2 mixing bowls for melting chocolate if you're not doing it on the stove, and obviously a measuring cup if you need it. So let's get this video started. Okay, so on a piece of parchment paper, you're gonna measure 9 to 12 inch rectangle, and then you're gonna take off the excess wax or parchment paper that's left over. You flip this over so that you don't get any of the ink on your bark. So flip that over when you're done. Do chocolate melted on the stove, like the legitimate way, but then I was like, no, can't do that because Kenley is getting cranky and she won't last. So what I'm gonna do is take a bowl and I'm gonna microwave it just because I'm melting it. If it was something I'm dipping, maybe different, but with bark, it should be fine. So you wanna chop these finely, and I'll show you that right now. So I'm gonna chop both of these chocolate bars and then melt them in the microwave slowly so they don't burn. Oh my God, I won the golden ticket. So now we have our finely crushed chocolate. I'm gonna grab a red spoon, that way I can make sure all the chocolate comes out even. So one of these thingamajiggers. Much easier, and got either the little chocolate, how come I can't think of it? I could've got the chocolate little morsels or something that's easier, but I like making my life difficult, it's fun. Okay, so I'm gonna take this over to the microwave, and I'm slowly gonna watch this because you don't want it to burn. So while the chocolate is melting, the next thing that it says to do once you remove from heat, you pour the chocolate into the rectangle, and using a cake spatula like one of these, you're gonna even it out in the triangle. You're gonna sprinkle with 1/2 of your crushed peppermints and then chill until set for 15 minutes. Oh, I'm gonna start chopping up my peppermint. I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking.
Thank you. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Spread even on the parchment paper or wax paper, whatever you prefer. What are you doing, Missy? You're gonna hurt your fingers. Take half of what you chopped for peppermints. Kenley, let go. You're gonna take half of what you chopped for your peppermints and you're gonna sprinkle that on top.
Once or twice. By once or twice, I mean maybe a couple of hundred times. So let me redeem all myself.
Now you're gonna go ahead and take your finished layer and put it in the freezer for 15 minutes. Hashtag doesn't fit in the freezer. Hashtag good thing there's another freezer. Okay, so we have the freezer. We're gonna set the timer for 15 minutes. Just so the chocolate can set. And now I'm gonna clean up my mess and get prepared for the second layer. The recipe calls for the next part of chocolate. I forgot a piece of chocolate in the recipe. Instead of just 8 ounces of bittersweet chocolate and 8 ounces of white chocolate, you also need 8 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate, which is why I forgot. So good thing I had chocolate in the house, but I'm using, instead of semi-sweet, because I don't really like semi-sweet, I'm gonna be using just milk chocolate Hershey's chips, because those are really good, and these will be easy to melt. And you're gonna use your semi-sweet chocolate. Obviously you can use that, or if you like milk chocolate, that's fine. You're gonna do 8 ounces of that. You're gonna put the peppermint extract in that too, and the heavy cream. So the recipe calls for 3/4 of a teaspoon of the peppermint extract, and then it also calls for 6 tablespoons of heavy cream. I'm gonna have to edit this like 70 times. Okay. I just wanna have some fun. Don't tell me what could be done. You know you like it, but it drives you insane. You know you like it, but it drives you insane. You know you like it, but you're scared of the shame. What you want, what you gonna do? You know you like it, but it drives you insane. Once this chocolate is melted, you're gonna wanna let it cool for about 5 minutes. And just get your stuff set up. This is the first layer, and we're gonna pour this second layer on top of this one. Our timer for 40 minutes and put that in the freezer. Santa hat, so it's, you know, festive. Hey, how you doing? How's my Santa hat? Okay, so Kenley is sleeping right now, which is fantastico, so I can finish this up, and it is about 4:20, so
that's that. I just chopped up all my white chocolate, and this is what we're going to be doing next. So let me grab the chocolate out of the freezer. This is the finished two layers, and now we have our white chocolate to do. So let's go ahead and put that in the bowl. Get this baby in here. All right, we're gonna microwave this. Have your spatula with you so that you can mix this puppy around. Okay, so when you have the white chocolate warmed, you have to quickly pour it over the layer, the second layer, and spread it evenly, and then put the peppermints on top, and then chill for 20 minutes, and you're finished. Finished product and put it in the freezer for 20 minutes and you're finished until we cut it. So this is what it looks like. Ugh, so good. In the freezer for 20 minutes, we'll set our timer. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Okay guys, so our peppermint bark is all done out of the freezer for the last 20 minutes. Now what we gotta do is cut it. So we're gonna move the legitimate parchment paper to a cutting board, and it tells you to trim away uneven edges of the rectangle, cut the bark crosswise into 2-inch wide strips, and then cut each strip crosswise into 3 sections, and then cut each section diagonally into 2 triangles. Like, holy crap. Okay, let's do this.
Filled with decor, fashion, vlog, challenge videos. Remember when I put whipped cream in your face? Mm-hmm. What'd you think about that?
I thought it was horrible.
Hi everyone, my name is Marissa and my channel is Marissa is a Mommy. On my channel, I'm going to be make these cute little Santa hat cheesecake bites. So if you'd like to see how to make them, go ahead and check out my channel.
Hey guys, head on over to our channel and check out our DIY baby photography video. Yay! Merry Christmas!
Hey everyone, I'm Karen from KK&J and we're doing baby DIY photography for the holidays if you guys want to come over and check it out.
Hello everybody, my name is Rachel. I'm from Rachel and Babies, and over on my channel I have made this cute DIY burlap deer canvas. If you guys are interested in seeing how I made this, definitely go check out my video.
We didn't see you there. Hey guys, I am Chloe. This is Wesley. My channel is Chloe Tuvel. I'm doing a Christmas ornament DIY project, so if you want to tune in and check it out, that would be awesome.